Thank you for joining me. Today we're looking at cameras and also cameras for every budget. So whether you've got $20-$30, you've got a DSLR camera here. Nothing wrong with that. Beautiful camera, takes 1080p video as well as 20 megapixel photographs. Obviously that's an option. We've got an action camera. We've got crop sensor DSLR camera. And then if you want to get the big guns out, you got the full frame DSLR camera. We have got options for mirrorless cameras as well, which is like the latest option. But the main topic today is we're going to check out what camera you can get at what price, and does it have to be a fancy DSLR camera, because it doesn't need to be. So I'm going to bring up a few different listings, give you examples. We're going to see what's the pricing, is it worth buying it, and what your budget is. So hang about after this short, I'm going to keep it under 10 minutes. I'm going to do like a full on specs load for you and you're going to see everything. So let's have a look at some of these cameras and we'll discuss them. So what we'll do right now is we'll have a look at a couple of cameras and see where we are sitting. I'm showing you a current camera there, which is going to be the top of the range, top of today's range of budget options I'm looking at. So we're looking at $700-ish. So just so you know what we're looking at, starting at $300 going up to $700. We might drop in a few cameras below that price as well. We will do. So right now I am looking at a Panasonic Lumix. If you go on Amazon and type in cheap camera or photo camera, this is one of the ones that they recommend. Is it a good camera? Let's have a look. So it's an FZ80. It's a digital camera. It's something in between a point and shoot and a DSLR camera. So you're going to be expecting like a decent size camera. It won't be too small, it won't be too big. It looks the part, which is sometimes people like looking like a photographer, you know. If it looks like a DSLR, wow, I'm good. So that's something to consider. Okay, so 18.1 megapixels, which is adequate. We've got image stabilization, which will help you if you're taking photographs or video. If you're hand holding it, it gets rid of that hand movement. It's going to be a nice zoom lens, so you have got a option to zoom. It's built in, the lenses, so you can't change it. And it's touch enabled and it will do 4K video. As a starter camera and a budget camera, if you're looking to get someone a camera that is not too familiar with photography, this might be a good camera for them, because it's going to be firstly easy to use because everything's contained in the camera. It's $297.99, so like a decent amount of money, but it works well because you've got a number of standard things. You've got long zoom, you've got image stabilization, you've got 4K video, it'll take photographs, so it'll keep most people happy. So I think that would be like a nice option for holidays, for someone who's getting into photography, a camera for parents maybe, something like that, if they're not into photos as much as like having the ability to change lenses and put like new lenses on. That's something to think about. In addition to that, separately, they have got a few models in that camera. You can look at different specs. How about if you're a bit more action orientated? How do you say that word? Orientated. Yeah, that word. We'll have a look at something which you're probably not expecting. You probably thought I'll show you like a GoPro and an action camera. But I have Olympus TUF TG6 camera. It's a waterproof camera and it looks quite fancy. It's like a bit built to be robust. It's like a point and shoot camera, but like an Iron Man point and shoot camera. That's like a decent way of explaining it. It's got like loads of red on it and like extra layers of protection. So it's designed to be waterproof up to 50 feet, about 15 meters underwater. So if you're doing any type of surveying or underwater scuba diving, but not too deep, this might be an option for you. If you're doing survivalist type stuff like TA Outdoors style videos and that might be a good option for you for making videos. It will do good in photo and video. It's lightweight. If video is not your main purpose, like if you're enjoying the situation and want video and photo as a secondary thing, as a memory, then it's perfectly fine and it doesn't take a lot of storage space. It's like quite small, it's handheld size. So that's a good option in terms of a secondary one. Pricing wise, we're thinking $450. So now this is where it comes down to, do you want to spend $450 and get a DSLR camera, which is slightly bigger, better quality and lens compatibility changing stuff, but you can have a bigger package. However, if weight and lightweight options are important. Maybe you want to spend a bit more to get a smaller form factor camera. That's why I'm showing you the option as a budget, because it's kind of catering to certain needs. So that's a nice option. Apart from that, how about a Sony Cybershot? You remember Sony Cybershots? Again, this is similar to the first Lumix camera we saw. It's going to be like a bridge, so not really a DSLR and not really a point and shoot, is in between. But again, it's a nice option for video and photo capabilities. Sony Cybershot H300 is the model, 20 megapixels. So I reckon as an option to give you straightforward photos and video, if that's your thing, then that is going to be a nice option. It's got image stabilization options through its optical sensor, so that's slightly different. Apart from that, I'm going to bring up a good old cheap option, $143, Canon PowerShot 180 digital camera. So this is like a proper point and shoot camera. So why would you want to use this, and what's the purpose of it? Why not use your mobile phone? If you want a camera dedicated as a camera and you don't want to put your mobile into that situation, because you could easily drop your mobile phone and everything's gone because you're banking and everything's on those these days, you can have a dedicated camera just for what a camera does, like back to good old days where cameras were cameras. So that's a good option, and the price is $143, so that's not too bad. Like, that's like a lower budget option. If you want to go in between, you want to be good quality, you want small size, and you don't want to spend loads of money, but you still want good quality, then there's something in between that. Canon PowerShot digital camera, G7X. So this is like, think of it like a fancy, not a DSLR camera, a fancy point and shoot, better than a point and shoot, and good for video and vlogging and lightweightness. It's not as tough as the tough one we looked at, the Olympus tough camera, but it's a good option. It's got 1-inch sensor, which means it's a bigger sensor, so you get overall better quality in terms of photos and the depth of field and that. So that is $629. Again, this is where we're looking at sizing and comparison. So like, for example, you don't want to have a massive camera like that. That would be a good alternative because it's going to give you that compact form, and you're paying $629. So what are we actually getting for that? So you're going to get features, a 1-inch 20 megapixel sensor, so it's a bigger sensor than normal. You've got aperture at 1.8. so if you're familiar with apertures and photo, that's basically how well it will show you background blur. I'll put it in like a layman's way. So 1.8 would give you a nice background blur. When you're in front of the camera, it'll be nice and sharp, you will be sharp. It's background blur, depth of field, people refer to it in different ways, but I try and say in many ways depending on how you like to listen to or hear it. So yes, built-in Wi-Fi, and it's a nice camera. It's a nice straight to the point camera. People won't give you funny looks with that. Like, it's a good quality camera, but it's not so big that you look like a paparazzi taking those photographs. So that's like a nice option. How about if you want the conventional DSLR but not too big, then the camera that I brought about 3 months ago now, and I live streamed with it on my live stream show, I changed my current Canon camera to this camera, which I'm showing you on screen now, as a good budget option. It's about $700. So it's not breaking the bank. You're getting a camera, you're getting a lens with the camera. It's part of a kit. You've got overall good quality photographs, video, as well as live streaming capabilities. So if you buy yourself a HDMI capture card, you can actually live stream with the camera, and it performs really well for live streaming. And that's what my setup is. So I've got a Camlink card that I use for live streaming with this camera that I'm showing you on screen. And for podcast listeners, that is our Canon EOS Rebel SL3, known as a 250D in the UK and some countries. So overall, looking at cameras for every budget, you've seen a number of options there. Hopefully that's helping you in your deciding, well, your budget and how much you want to spend. But that's giving you something more to think about. If you're not sure what camera you want to get, drop a message below and let me know what you're thinking about buying, and we'll do a bit of research. And next time I do another video, I'll make sure to include those cameras. I didn't include any mirrorless cameras here. Canon M50, great option. You can look at the new Sony ZV, which is a mirrorless camera option. You've got A7 III, but then obviously that is a higher priced camera. But again, there are some more camera comparisons here, so I'll see you on that next video.